21 Chump Street, the musical. I've always wondered what it would mean to do one of our radio stories as a musical. You know, I was taken to so many musicals as a kid, and I think because of that, my basic sense of what makes a satisfying story actually comes from musicals, much more than from TV or movies. If you think about like the classic old musicals, Fiddler on the Roof, or even Chorus Line, it's like they're funny at the beginning, and then there's something really emotional, and they're about some bigger idea. They take you into this world. I just love that. And so what you're about to hear is our first attempt at a musical based on journalism. Probably 70 to 80% of what you're about to hear is verbatim quotes from interviews. The rest is artistic invention. I'll say that up front. It's based on a true story you may remember from our radio program. Back in May 2011 at a bunch of high schools in Palm Beach County, Florida, a group of young police officers were sent undercover to pose as students. They went to classes, they ate in the cafeteria, they had fake Facebook accounts, of course. There had been complaints about drugs being sold at these schools. That's what they were there to deal with. And what happened next in this one school was transformed into a musical by a team of people who usually do this on Broadway. Pretty much everybody involved in this, the cast, the chorus, the musicians, the director, Michael Mayer, all from Broadway. Words and music are by Lin-Manuel Miranda. Probably best known. Probably best known for writing and starring in The Heights. He will be your narrator.
The plan was called Operation D-Minus, and one of the schools included in the plan was Park Vista Community High School, where a kid named Justin Laboy,
that's me,
an 18-year-old honor roll student,
I get straight A's, man,
was in the last semester of his senior year. Justin could hardly believe his luck when a very pretty girl showed up.
Naomi.
In not one, but two of his classes.
Naomi.
She sat in front of him. He switched seats.
Naomi.
The last name she used was
Rodriguez.
Justin, what drew you to Naomi initially?
Man, she used to fall asleep in class. She was a light-skinned Puerto Rican Dominican, long hair, mature in a body like, whoa.
Like, whoa.
That's not the only reason I liked her, though. She said she moved with her mother to Florida from New York,
where dreams are made.
Well, so did I. So I said hi. She seemed mature and I talked more. And I was like, what the heck I gotta do to be with you?
What the heck I gotta do?
What the heck I gotta do to be with you?
What the heck I gotta do?
Tell me who I gotta be for you to be with me.
You told her all this in class?
Well, yeah. I texted her, you know. I was like, what the heck I gotta do to be with you?
LOL, LOL, LOL.
What the heck I gotta do to be with you?
R-O-F-L-O-L.
Tell me who I gotta be for you to be with me.
Smiley face.
Yes! Next thing you know, we're texting day and night. I trust her right away.
Like, whoa.
Hey, yo, I never met anyone like her, bro. Yo, she listens to all my problems. I let her copy all my homework. And then I lay it all on the line. And she was like,
no,
no, no. She didn't say no exactly, I don't know.
No,
no,
no. Yeah, I was surprised, I'm a pretty great guy.
So
I decided I needed to step my game up.
Oh,
oh, oh,
oh. It's too late to be shy. So I got in front of the whole class one day and I serenaded her. I was like, what the heck I gotta do?
What the heck I gotta do?
What the heck I gotta do to be with you?
What the heck I gotta do?
Tell me who I gotta be for you to go to prom with me.
You asked her to the prom.
Yeah, I danced and everything.
Naomi,
I know there's a reason you were transferred here to me. It's destiny. Naomi, you know me. Will you go to prom with me?
I'll think about it.
She'll think about it.
Yes!
I didn't say yes. I didn't say I'll think about it. I can't tell you my real name. But yes, I can confirm that I did get asked to the prom.
The undercover officer who posed as Naomi is 25 years old, a new recruit with the Palm Beach Police Force.
My assignment, to pose as a senior and find out who's buying, who's selling. Mostly pills and weed, you would not believe how easy it is to get pills and weed.
What's the hardest part?
Cafeteria. Imagine hundreds of teenagers yelling and running full speed, and the lack of deodorant. Let's just say I would drink at the end of the day. Seriously, these kids need to learn there are consequences in life. If I'm doing my job and I'm doing it right, I am making life safer one school at a time.
So we asked you to prom.
Right. I gave every excuse. I said it's too expensive, which is totally true, by the way. I told him, look, I'm just a transfer. I wouldn't feel comfortable with all your friends. And it's true, you make friends on the job, then it ends. You meet kids who are sensitive, smart, and defenseless. Those are the ones you remember, the ones that you think about after you're gone. Seriously, these kids need to learn there are consequences in life. If I'm doing my job and I'm doing it right, I am making life safer one school at a time.
Meanwhile,
what the heck I gotta do to be with you? What the heck I gotta do? Tell me who I gotta be for you to be with me.
Do you smoke?
What?
Do you smoke weed?
No, I don't, but if that's what you need, I can find some for you. I can be your supply.
You would do that for me.
I can be your guide.
Oh! Seriously, these kids yes! need to learn there are no! consequences in life. If I'm doing my job and I'm doing it right, I am making life safer one school at a time.
Listen, I'm not a drug dealer, so it's not like she asked me this day and I got it for her the very next day. It took me a while, you know? So, I mean, I'm trying to get it and I can't get it.
What are you thinking as you're trying to get this pot to sell her?
I'm thinking, what the heck am I doing? I never done this before, so I'm really scared and skeptical at the same point. So I asked my homeboy, and he's like,
I don't know, man, why are you asking me?
Because I don't hang out with guys like that.
What did you end up doing?
I called a cousin who called a cousin who called his friend, who called a couple dozen cousins cause it doesn't end.
My cousin Justin's looking for a little something something for a certain someone, some girl he wants to be touching.
Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something.
We were just discussing our cousin Justin. Wasn't Justin the cousin who just made the honor roll, got the colleges buzzing?
Are we close to our cousin Justin? Are we supposed to trust him?
Are we thugs to our cousin Justin? We don't sell drugs.
Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something.
Did you get it yet?
No, I'm about to get it.
Is your dealer a student?
I got you, girl. Don't sweat it.
Let me know when you got it.
As soon as I can.
I'll find a way to repay you, Justin.
Oh, man!
Yo, what is up with this fussing? This isn't up for discussion. This is our cousin coming to us. He's our blood and we love him.
Ah, look at Justin. He blushing.
Our little Justin is crushing.
Sorry for rushing the judgment. Why should we get you these drugs?
Love.
What?
Only if you believe in love.
Love.
Only if you believe in love. Love.
stuffs.
I hand my cousin 25 ducats, I'm sweating buckets. He hands me a sandwich bag with some little green nuggets. I got it for you.
XO, cool.
You want it now?
See you at school.
Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something. Everybody's got a cousin who can hook them up with something.
According to the police, Justin is a drug dealer. Maybe Justin didn't know where to get drugs, maybe he did. What we know is this. The next day, Justin brought a rolled up baggie of marijuana to school for Naomi.
And I was like, oh my God, I'm actually about to do this. So we was in class and I sat down right next to her and she was like,
Justin, do you have it?
Yeah, I do. And I was like, you know what? We're gonna wait for a few. Cause I didn't wanna be like, oh hey, and just slide it in her hand or whatever. So we waited. And she was like,
okay, put it in my purse.
So I slid it right in there. And then she was like,
okay, here, take the money. Justin, here, take the money.
I don't want your money. Got this just for you. Keep your money. It's nothing I won't do for you. I'll come through for you every time. Just in time.
Justin, listen, please just take the money.
Naomi, I know there's a reason you were
transferred here to me. You're making me feel guilty. Take the money.
Naomi, I know there's a reason this is
you really did come to me.
Naomi, you
know
me. Just in time
for me. Take the money. Take the money. Take the money.
I don't want your money.
The teacher's coming. Take this money, Justin.
Keep your money.
We aren't done. Please take this money, Justin.
Justin would later find out it's a felony in Florida to sell marijuana, and the penalty is even harsher for selling it on school property. By taking the money, Justin had made an irreversibly bad decision, and since he was over 18, he was legally an adult when he made it.
Seriously, these kids need to learn there are consequences in life. I am doing my job. I am doing it right. I am making life safer one school at a time.
In May, the police arrested 31 students at several schools. Justin was one of them.
Freeze! You have the right to remain silent!
Everybody who sold drugs to undercover cops is busted!
Everybody who sold drugs to undercover cops is busted!
Everybody who sold drugs to undercover cops is busted!
Everybody who sold drugs to undercover cops is busted!
He spent a week in jail wondering what would happen next.
It's your word against hers, the cops of every text.
The cops of every text, the cops of every text.
Don't worry, girl, I got the stuff, I got you.
He knew he'd lose in court. He had to take a plea.
3 years probation, I pled guilty to the felony.
What? A felony? A nickel bag's a felony. What?
Justin, say goodbye to college, they got you.
These kids need to wake up. I don't want to go too much into it, but drugs hit really close to home for me. Saw the effects growing up of cocaine, marijuana, ecstasy.
With family members?
Yes. I've seen what it can do to a family. That's all I want to say about it.
Do you wish someone like you had done this type of work?
Yes. And I hope someone like me keeps doing it. Still. There are kids you remember, the ones that you think about after you're gone.
During the week he spent in jail, Justin couldn't help but think about Naomi.
She was a light-skinned, Puerto Rican, Dominican, long hair, mature in the body like, whoa. That's not the only reason I liked her, though. Yo, if it had been a guy that came up to me asking me for drugs, I would have said no. I would have said, get out of my face. I don't hang out with people like that. It's because it was her.
Have you talked to her since all of this happened?
No. I would love to. I would love to have that conversation.
What do you think you would say?
I would say, what the heck did you do? What the heck did you do, Naomi? What the heck did you do?
Our cast, Lindsay, Mendez is Naomi, Anthony Ramos is Justin, the chorus, Alex, Boniello, Gerard, Canonico.